USA Radio News with Rick Vincent.
Who hasn't heard these words?
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Half a century ago today, Apollo 11 astronaut Neil Armstrong makes history as the first human to touch the moon's surface. Speaking to reporters at the White House after a meeting with Apollo 11 astronauts, President Trump was asked about Boris Johnson being the leading candidate for UK Prime Minister.
I think Boris will straighten it out. I like Boris Johnson. I always have. He's a different kind of a guy, but they say I'm a different kind of a guy, too. We get along well. I think we'll have a very good relationship.
Trump also saying outgoing Prime Minister Theresa May did a bad job with the Brexit disaster. Trump voicing confidence that Johnson would fix the situation. You're listening to USA Radio News. A federal judge is upholding the Trump administration's expansion of cheaper short-term health insurance plans as an alternative to the Affordable Care Act's costlier comprehensive insurance. Protesters are demanding the resignation of Puerto Rico's Governor Ricardo Rossello after leaked chats between him and his inner circle revealed profanity-laced homophobic messages about fellow politicians and members of the media. Democratic presidential candidate and former Secretary of Housing and Urban Development Julian Castro.
It's clear that Governor Rossello can no longer be effective. I stand with Puerto Ricans who are protesting in the streets, his administration.
The governor has apologized for his language but has refused calls to step down. After a power outage left part of New York City in darkness for hours, a major heat wave has officials eyeing the city's electric grid. President of Con Edison, Timothy Colley.
We've identified the cause of the relay misoperation. We've isolated those.
This is USA Radio News. Funeral arrangements are set for a retired Supreme Court justice. USA's Radio Network's Winnie King has details on that story.
The body of former Justice John Paul Stevens will lie in repose at the Supreme Court on Monday. Members of the public can pay their respects from 10:30 a.m. to 8 p.m. following a private ceremony in the court's Great Hall. Stevens died earlier this week at age 99. He'll be buried in a private service at Arlington National Cemetery, the 13th justice to be buried there. For USA Radio News, I'm Wendy King.
A new study reported in the Annals of Internal Medicine reports taking vitamins and mineral supplements won't help you live a longer life or reduce your risk of cardiovascular problems. We get more on that story from John Clemens.
It's often been said you can't out-supplement a diet that is unhealthy. Dr. Andrew Chow is with the Council for Responsible Nutrition.
One of the important roles that supplements play is to help fill those nutrient gaps that are left by a suboptimal diet. They're not a replacement for the diet. They are a supplement to the diet. Hence, the name fits perfectly.
Many Americans attempt a perfect diet but miss the mark.
We all strive, perhaps, some more than others, to try to obtain a perfect or an optimal diet, but more often than not, we fall short.
I'm John Clemens.
And for USA Radio News, I'm Rick Vincent.